Now it is time for some home design tips from the handy Hamish Dodd. Good morning, Hamish.
Good morning.
You've been stirring.
I do. I feel like Mark. So I'm mixing away here. Okay, that's right. We're going to have a little chat today about tips for when you're going to do some painting yourself at home.
Okay, good.
And cover off a few things that I've seen that have gone wrong over time.
Have you been to Resene?
Yes. I've been down to the Resene store and the guys were incredibly helpful and they loaded me up with all the bits and pieces that I thought are important that you should see.
Okay. Right.
First of all, you've done a bit of this, haven't you?
Well, I have done a fair bit of it. And you'll notice that, first of all, I'm using a stirrer. Clearly, it's the largest stirrer you can buy on the market. You can get smaller ones. It's important to stir your paint fully before you start painting. Otherwise, the tint drips through. You can't really see it in there.
How long do you have
Until it's completely mixed in, basically.
Well, how long?
It depends on the size of the pot. Well, so far, I've been going about 40 seconds, and I'm only partway there. So I'm going to continue with some preparation tips.
I'm going to do two things at once.
This is like patting your head and rubbing your tummy.
I'll hold it up if you want.
Okay, if you wouldn't mind, Mel. Mel is currently holding masking tape. Now, the yellow, okay, we'll say advance. That is what you want if you're an amateur. Now, the reason for this is it stands up well under UV light. So should you start your project and not complete your project in the given weekend you should do, it's not going to bond to the windows, because that's a major problem. You see people leave their masking tape around their window frames for 3 months, and next thing you know, it doesn't come off the windows properly. Mm. And plus, when you paint up to it, you're going to end up with a mess. Soon, I'm going to show you what you should be doing without using masking tape. I'm going to have a go at cutting in and showing you a straight line.
Okay.
So I'm mixing my paint. Now, what else have I got going on sitting around here? We can't do the image. I'm going to pour this paint for you into this tray, and I'm going to show you how to load a roller, okay?
Okay.
This is another important thing. I'm going to pop that in there.
What's the empty tin for?
Well, that empty tin is when you're using paint and you're walking around the house, you should have a small pot to put a little bit of paint in. It's easier to hold and manage rather than trying to paint out of the big tins, okay? You can get these from your Resene store, you can use a baked bean tin.
And you know what else is good? Because sometimes I've spilt a whole tin of paint and I've lost the whole tin. We just have one of those little paint pots.
Yes.
You only lose that little bit.
When you're clumsy like you, Mike.
I'm going to pour paint now. Okay. I have to concentrate. I'm not good.
Pour the paint.
Right. There we go. So we're just going to put a little bit of grey in there. We'll pretend that there aren't lots of runs coming down the side.
Okay.
Oh, I'm going to put a little bit more in.
Okay.
Why are you tipping it there and not in there?
Well, I'm letting it run down, Mike.
Right.
Does that mean it's not very well stirred there because you've got your tin there?
That could be a problem. While we're waiting for that to settle to the bottom, I'm going to show you the difference in two types of rollers. Now, lately I've been to clients' houses and they've said to me, why do my walls feel rougher now they've been repainted than they did previously?
Yeah.
That comes down to the selection of the roller sleeve you use.
Okay, so get that right.
Yeah, so the finer, smoother finish roller, that'll give you a nice even coat. I've seen painters roll doors that look like they've been sprayed.
Okay.
If you get more of a, shall we say, embossed finish, the orange peel look, it's because a heavier grade roller like this has been used.
And is it a bad thing?
Well, it's a personal thing. A lot of people prefer a smoother finish. So if you are buying rollers, ask, get advice. If you're getting someone to paint your house, ask them what kind of roller they're going to use. Okay?
Nice. Okay, good tips.
Now I'm going to show you how to load a roller.
Okay, nice.
I'm unwrapping everything as we go.
Good.
I'm putting our roller on.
Using the smooth finish one, I know.
Smooth finish one, it's my favourite.
Right.
Okay, now here's the catch.
Oh, you mean load it as in load the paint?
I'm going to actually put paint on a roller on national television. Now here's the point. You don't go,
Right.
We dip it in so as it's half done.
Yes.
We bring it out and then we roll it down the groove section to get an even coverage on the roller.
Okay.
Now the first time you're doing this, of course,
it's going to take a while to get an even
coverage.
You know, I know how to do this because I did a TV show where I had to go and fix up kids' bedrooms.
Did you paint?
And I painted.
You're a marvel.
Did you know what?
See how we have an even tone on there? Now I'll hold it above my head. You'll notice. That's right. That's right, folks. There are no drips. Very important if you're painting a ceiling also. If you are painting a wall, you start low, move to high, and start with a W fashion. And it's very important not to let the edges dry off while you're doing it.
Okay, lovely.
Now, when you're finished rolling, or say you're taking a small break,
yes,
an easy thing to do, well, not that long a break, but a small break,
you can pop the roller
into a plastic bag. Oh, it's not rolling up. There it is. And it rolls up. That'll stop the roller drying, so now you can go away and have your small cup of tea and bicky, okay?
Great tip. Nice tip.
Okay, last thing I'm going to do is try not to embarrass myself here.
Yes, because you've got 30 seconds.
30 seconds.
No pressure, Hamish. 30 seconds.
If you're not going to use masking tape and want to have a go at cutting in, the key is to get the correct kind of brush.
Yep.
We'll see here. I bought red just to embarrass myself even more if I possibly can.
Right.
And
because it's an angle brush, isn't it?
It's an angle brush
for cutting in.
So the point is you press down and draw along, okay?
And then you can go back in and you splay the bristles out, and that is how you actually start to draw your straight line, okay?
Oh, nice, that's pretty tidy.
You don't go wah, wah, wah and end up with a wavy line, okay? It's press down and draw back nice and straight.
Flick. Got it. Hamish, nice work.
Boom.
Nice. Okay, good work.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, okay. Now, clearly, Rosine can help you out with any of these tips as well.
They can.
Nice work. Make sure you pop in and see them. And for more details, you can head to rosine.co.nz. Thank you very much, Hamish. That was awesome.
Thank you.